will be many false prophets that will be coming deceiving many people. Now there are people who are asking money, there are prophets and pastors that are asking money for prayers, asking money for somebody who wants to for somebody who wanted to be prayed for, somebody. Even the prophecy are done with the money, even the preachings are done with the money. Everything has become of money, and they are now commercializing the gospel. They are now selling the blood of Jesus, they are now selling the gospel, they are now selling their prayers, even the prophecy. They are selling even the prophecy. What is that? Even the gospel of sowing a seed, that now you want to be prayed, now you are told that now you have to plant a certain amount of money. You have to plant a certain amount of money, and in that letter, that is a gospel of sowing money. That is selling the gospel. That is selling the gospel, selling prophecy, selling even hearing, selling prayers with money. That is the gospel that God is saying. Because Jesus Christ, when Jesus Christ came in this world, he came and he preached to us for free. He came and delivered the sick and even casted out demons for free. Everything was free through the blood of Jesus Christ. And so this gospel that is selling the blood of Jesus, this gospel that is selling prayers, selling prophecy, selling hearing, selling even preaching by money, that is not the gospel that Jesus Christ preached. And this is why God is saying that the blood of Jesus Christ was free. We received the blood of Jesus by free. If God was selling the salvation, therefore we could not be saved, because we are poor. We don't have money to buy that kind of salvation. Even the poor people cannot receive that salvation. Therefore, that gospel of prayer, of asking money before you pray, that is another gospel of hell, and that is the gospel of false prophet that have come. Because when you look, if Paul, there was Paul, all the prophet and all apostles, Paul, Stephen, all those people, they did not ask money in order to pray for people. They did not ask money in order to prophesy, in order to preach. They did not ask money. But the prophets that are sent out, they are asking money in order to preach, in order to pray, in order to do certain thing, even of deliverance, to help the sheep of God. They are asking money. You see, that is not the gospel of God, because Paul did never ask money. Even Jeremiah never asked money. Even Isaiah, he did not ask any money for a prophecy. He did not ask any money or sowing a certain plant of seed or sowing a certain money in the letter. He did not sow a seed. He did not tell people to sow seed. That is another gospel. God is saying that those people are now taking advantage of the sheep of God. They are now taking the advantage of the sheep of God in the church. They are taking advantage of those who are sick, advantage of those people who are in need, advantage of those people who are waiting, those who people who are in problem. They are now taking advantage in form of money and keeping a boundary of money, that if you need to be prayed, then you have to pay a certain amount. If you want to be prayed, if you want to be done deliverance, even if you want to receive the baptism, receive even salvation, you have to pay a certain amount of money. That is gospel of the devil. That is gospel of hell. Gospel that is coming with the gain of this money. Gospel preachers and prophets and apostles and people who are filled with the love of money. They are filled with the greediness of money. They do not fear God at all. All they fear is about money. All they fear is about the account in the bank. They don't fear. They don't have the mercy of the sheep of God. What they are doing, they are looking upon your pocket. They are looking upon your money. But they are not there to help you, to deliver you out of your problem. That they are calling holy water. All those things are brought because of commercializing the gospel of God. They are there to commercial. They are there to market the blood of Jesus Christ. They are there so that they have come with all those kind of materials and anointing oil of selling, water of selling, even brooms of selling, everything they have, it is of selling. They have come with those things like a business people. They have come to market their fame. They have come to market them so that they may get money. They are gaining from the sheep of God. They are gaining from the church of God. And that is why even the gospel that they are preaching a gospel of gaining, are preaching a gospel of making many people to come in their church in order that they may receive money. Witches, if it is a witch who is performing thing, he have to ask you of money. If it is a satanist, a satanist in people, if they are performing their thing, they have to ask of money. So in the gospel of God, it is all about free. But when you see somebody asking of money, that is not sent by God. That is not sent by the Lord God Almighty, who came to us to die for us for free. So the poor people will not receive the gospel. They not receive healing, they not receive deliverance, they not receive salvation. Why? Because they don't have the money. That is not the pure gospel. That is not the true gospel. That is a false gospel. He did not send them to ask money before they pray. He did not send them to ask money before they baptize. He did not send them to go and ask money before the deliverance. God did not send them. Even after the deliverance, you should not ask money. God will provide you if it is God who called you. He will provide you. Look, the Bible is saying this in the book of Matthew chapter 10, verse 8. See, heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. You see, the Bible, the word of God says that it is when Jesus Christ was sending his disciples, it is when Jesus Christ was sending all the prophets, all apostles, and all his preachers, he sent them and told them, go and heal the sick, go and heal the sick, go and raise the dead, go and cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons, and freely you have received, freely give. You see, that freely you have received the gift of the Holy Spirit. Freely you should give. Freely you should heal. Freely you should lay your hand upon. Freely you should pray for people. Freely you should preach.